Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Kamaljit Singh Bakshi.
Thank you, Mr. Chair, for the opportunity to participate in this debate. Mr. Chair, first of all, I would like to congratulate the leadership of the ministers, Honorable Amy Adam, Honorable Paula Bennett, for their leadership in this justice sector. As it has been mentioned, Mr. Speaker, it is not just the policing or corrections, but we need to have look into the wider picture in the justice as well as the social sector, where we can address the issues which has been raised. I would like to also acknowledge Honorable Judith Collins for her leadership as a Minister of Police in the past. Mr. Speaker, the government, when came in power in 2008, we inducted 600 more frontline police officers who helped us to improve the law and order situation drastically. And that has been a main issue at that time, and that's why we are today the fourth safest country in the world, and we will continue to work upon it. And that was the past. In the future, the government has earlier this year announced by the Prime Minister and the Deputy Prime Minister that we will be having additional 1,125 more police officers to help the situation. It is very important we should understand that the numbers will help us to improve the law and order situation, but it is the wider spectrum, as the minister mentioned, that it is the social angle also has to be looked into, and we hope that this will help us. Mr. Speaker, we also rolled out the new technology, the new tools were provided to the police, which helped us that there were about more than equivalent to the 350 more police officers on the street because of the technology. They didn't have to go back to the police station to report what they have done. They are using the technology, the smartphones, to record the crime, and they are helping it. Mr. Speaker, this is what we are doing, and we have also provided them with the taser guns. They are in lockup, and they are available. If the situation requires, then they can use it. Mr. Speaker, the additional $500 million which has been allocated to the justice sector earlier this year will help us to provide more money to justice, corrections, and the police so that they can help out that to increase the safety of the people at their homes, in their community, at their businesses. Mr. Speaker, Mr. Nash mentioned that we have closed on few police stations or community police stations, but I can assure him that in days to come, we are helping 20 more police stations to be 24/7 so that they can provide the safety the people are looking at. Mr. Speaker, we have also provided additional 20 ethnic officers, which is very important to understand with the changing demography of New Zealand today, that we need more and more ethnic officers who can understand the culture, who can talk in the language they speak, so that they can have the benefit of their safety and their prospect. Mr. Speaker, we are also going to launch a non-emergency number, which will help people to put pressure off from the 111 number, and the non-emergency calls can be attended by this new number, which can connect them to the police officer, police stations, which are not 24/7. Mr. Speaker, we are also working on family violence, and we have made a lot of changes in the past so that the family violence can be addressed, and we can help the families to feel safe. Mr. Speaker, the interest in the getting recruited in the police is increasing, and more than 1,351 applications have been received earlier this year. Mr. Speaker, I would also like to touch upon the corrections part, which is also important because most of our prisons are being turned into the working prisons so that we can provide the training to the inmates so that when they come out in the society, they have got some skill where they can help themselves and their families to live a life with a mana, and they can be a self-respected person. Mr. Speaker, In 2015 and 16, a total of 176.
Kelvin Davis.